Hello, my beautiful Pisces. How are you? I want to welcome all new visitors. Thank you for stopping by. And I want to thank all of my subscribers who entered the contest for a free phone reading with me that I run monthly by liking, subscribing, sharing, and commenting. This is a Crosswatchers video. This is how your person of interest thinks, feels, their actions, everything that you need to know, or hopefully as much as we can get here today. And the card, the advice of the tarot for your person is breathe. Breathe. That is their energy. They're taking a deep breath. They're trying to figure out how to stay balanced. Time for a nap. They have been resting, and you might not have heard from them recently, but we'll see what's going on here, Pisces. Taking a break is always good. Even the ocean goes to low tide and takes a nap every day. Imagine, ooh, manifesting. Look at how beautiful those blues are. Just gorgeous. All right. So we're going to take a look and see how your person of interest with whom you are having a relationship, whether it's old or new or reconciliation, to see what their energy is in the recent past. What is Pisces love interest energy in the recent past? What is their love energy? There we go. Okay. Oh, whoa. Pisces, go big or go home. Look at you. Your person feels that you are the total embodiment of everything they could possibly wish or dream of. This is the planet Venus. When we look at astrology, this is Taurus. This person values you probably more than they've ever valued anyone. They think that you are absolutely love incarnate, blissful. They think the world of you. They could want to have children with you. And if they don't want children with you, but I do, you know, if you're at that point where you're either past that point or before that point, this person really sees you as their ideal. You are the gold standard in love. Okay, what is their current energy in this love relationship? Okay, I'm going to take these. Okay, Nine of Pentacles. That's Virgo energy. You have it together. They see you as a person. They feel about you that you're just really incredibly capable. You look great. They're impressed by you. They want to be you sometimes. Pisces, this person really sees you as having this beautiful bird. You're exotic. You groom. You look good. You smell good. You dress well. They see you as very successful, very desirable. That's their energy around you, is a strong level of desire to hang out with you, to be with you, to build something with you of value. What is going on? How do they see the situation? Overall, how do they see the situation between the two of you? Well, they see this as getting to know you, getting to know all about you. This is probably a new relationship for many of you. Maybe getting to know somebody that you've known for a period of time better or on a personal level. Page of Swords. That's Gemini energy. A lot of people call it the spy card, but in this particular deck, it's all about, they're reading about you. They could be looking you up on the internet. They think that you're lovely, and they want some enlightenment about who you are. They're curious. Remember the book Curious George? That was always so much fun. Curious George got himself into some scrapes, but he was always so cute because he was trying to learn. All right, so how they see you, how they view you, is a person who's always, oh, this is great. They view you as a person who's always learning something new, a student of life, that you're always learning and mastering something new. They see you as inquisitive, and that Eight of Pentacles leads to the Nine of Pentacles. They really put that a high value on that aspect of your personality. In their heart space, look at how gorgeous. This is Leo energy. And it's the infinity symbol. They feel as though you could be their forever person. Pisces, beautiful, fiery energy. Their animal attraction to you is really strong. And their human desire to be loyal and faithful to you is outstanding. Beautiful energy. Let's see how they see the situation moving forward. How do they see your relationship developing? Tower card, big changes ahead. We're going to clarify that. This is an epiphany. You have really taken this person by storm. You know, it also can be, and we'll clarify this. Okay. So this is surprise. And the surprise is that you may well be the first person that they really wanted to invest themselves in regards to a significant love relationship. We're going to clarify this a lot. Okay, so because I really want to understand that tower. Let's see, what else about the tower? What is it? So this person has the epiphany that they want to have a relationship in which give and take, equal give and take is a part of the relationship. Ooh, they want to marry you and it just is taking them by surprise. They have fantasies and thoughts that keep popping into their head that they want to marry you. They have had a history of difficulty in relationships and they are trying to become enlightened. This is Aquarius energy and this is Scorpio energy. So they are trying to learn. Beautiful, beautiful. All right, so what's hidden here? What is hidden for you, Pisces, in this relationship? What's hidden beneath the surface of this person, this love interest of yours? What is hidden in the energy? Ooh, they do spy on you. Now that is actually a card of spying. This person could actually drive by your house. This is like the intel unit. This is like, well, we have top secret clearance here, or we want to, and we want, they're coming along, they're probably liking your posts in a very benign way, but they have an intense interest to know who you are, what you are. It's really funny because I have a relative who is a retired Navy SEAL, and that person is always super curious, always like, what is that person thinking? What are they doing? What's their motivation? What's happening? Really like, I spy super spy. I spy Gemini, and that's a Gemini card. All right, the Seven of Swords is Aquarius energy, though. It is Aquarius, but they want to become enlightened again. Enlightened, and they will stay awake late at night trying to figure out who you are, what you are, what you're doing, what is she about, how can I win he or she. Oh, beautiful energy. This person is also very intellectual. This is Libra. It's Libra energy that says, I want to make sure I make an intelligent, enlightened decision. I want to take my emotions out of it, because Pisces, you guys are feels, you are in your feels a lot. And this indicates that they want to make sure that they have a good experience in the relationship. They want to be fair and balanced and equal. I love it. It's very egalitarian. Aquarius, right? The age of Aquarius. An age in which we are currently moving. So this person wants enlightenment in relationship, and the Tower card is epiphany and enlightenment. Sometimes it's not pleasant, but sometimes it's a great card. Okay, Three of Pentacles. They want to spend time with you. They want to get to know you better. You may have met this person through work, since we have a lot of coins. Coins are necessary for a relationship. If you want a future, you must have coins in a relationship. It's the grounded energy. So this tells me that they want to collaborate with you either in life, or they want to collaborate with you in relationship, or they actually collaborate with you by working with you and met you that way. But they really like hanging out with you. They like being social with you. But they especially like enjoying your intellect. The card, I was just shuffling without really thinking about it. And the Four of Cups comes up. In the past, they have not had fulfilling relationships. They have oftentimes been immature enough to not have the gratitude they should have. They've lost a love at some point in the past because they were pessimistic. And this person has to fight that sort of energy of not trusting, of feeling like they have to be, you know, undercover cops here. They must, and it does appear that they had a breakup that came out of the blue that was very destructive. The Nine of Swords says that this person stays awake at night because they have a fear of heartbreak. Pisces, wow. All right, so let's see what this beautiful Empress is here for your reading, Pisces. What is this beautiful Empress doing here in terms of how your person feels about you? Ten of Cups. This is the Nine of Cups. They want their happiness. They see you as a person with whom they can be happy. They want their Nine of Cups. They're feeling like, okay, I'm here with the party. Where is everybody? Where is my Pisces? Where is my Pisces? I want my Pisces. All right. Where's the Nine of Pentacles? That was a great card. It actually also means working on the relationship. The Queen of Pentacles reversed means that this person with Capricorn energy thinks that, one of the things they're studying is to see if you overvalue money. They're very curious about if you're looking for like just a rich partner. Now, Six of Cups says they don't think so. They feel as though, Pisces, you are loving and sweet and kind. They want to know your history, though. They definitely want to know your history. And look at the Empress. What they discover and what they learn is you embody the planet Venus. You are as loving. You are exactly what you say you are. And they are able to learn that over the next 3 months. Beautiful. Lovely. Let's see what the Imagine card is. Breathe. This is Breathe. What is it that they need to take a deep breath about? Oh, they've been heartbroken in the past. They have been so crushed. They were with somebody who put them in a third-party situation, and that person didn't tell them about the third party. Ooh, I spy Gemini. No wonder they're coming in with that energy. Now, the Knight of Wands, this person that hurt them in the past was a player who left them behind, quite honestly. It looks very painful. They're recovering, but they want to take a leap of faith with you. The Ace of Cups, they're willing to have new love. They want love. Their cup runneth over. Again, this is very, you know, very strong Venus energy. And Venus is in retrograde right now, so people are really looking at relationships under the microscope. The Five of Wands indicates that when there's conflict, this person withdraws. They do not do conflict well. They're not good at conflict resolution because they become quite overwhelmed. Their first reaction to conflict is to take a nap. Their second reaction is, why does that person always have to fight with me? Their third reaction is, I want nothing to do with a war zone. I don't want egotistical anything going on with my Pisces. Beautiful. I love it. That's Leo energy. The Eight of Swords is Gemini energy. Taking a nap. Everybody should take a nap, right? We're not doing without naps after COVID. All right. I'm sorry. I digress. All right. This person. Ooh, look at this. They are coming in fast and hot towards you. They have you in their sights, and they are not going to hold back. This person is rushing towards you as we speak. Cancerian energy. You know, when we look at the Empress, we look at the, that's Taurus, but very much the same loving, nurturing energy. This person will fight for love. They will chase love, and they will present themselves and make themselves servant to their love. All right, why is the Leo card here of strength? Beautiful. Oh, here we go. We have the Scorpio King. You are Pisces. You are a wonderful, very compatible match. This is a person who loves deeply, who loves almost so deeply that they don't even want to talk about it. But they're also very enlightened, and they're very loyal. Oh, Pisces, you have a gentle spirit here who's very kind and very sweet, who didn't always use good judgment in the past with who they became involved with. Why is a judgment card reversed for a beautiful Pisces? That's also all about making decisions. And this person, yep, this person has been wounded in the past. They are imagining something better. Yep, they put, oh good, they've healed. Scorpio energy again. This person is returning to the ability to love again after being hurt and after being treated very badly and very roughly by another. I love this. This is beautiful. Why is the Seven of Swords here, Pisces? Why is the Seven of Swords here for our beautiful Pisces friends? The Nine of Wands. This person is very defensive. They're on guard. They've been through the mill in love. They're, oh, wow. Okay, well, we have the Four of Pentacles. They're holding on to their heart. They're holding on to you. They're holding on to their love. They could be a little bit controlling, but not so much controlling as a little bit possessive. They definitely have a tendency to hold back on their emotions also. Look at this mess that dropped on the floor. All right, so the Tower card is reversed. They do not think that you're going to dump them on their head. They're building trust slowly. I'm going to take these cards. We have the Eight of Pentacles. This person does see you as a person with whom they can become successful in relationship. The Four of Cups tells us, oh, wow. The Four of Cups says that in the past, they weren't always appreciative of love. They looked at the negative side, the cup half empty, when in actuality, there has been love in their life. They were so busy looking at the negative side, they have invoked the power of a guardian angel to protect this love that they are developing for you. I'm going to take this card. Three of Cups, beautiful. See the Nine of Cups? This person sees you as one of their best friends. And I'm going to leave that sample this. Yes, in the past they were left out in the cold. I'm going to take all these just as backstory, because that's what I think they are. Yeah, Ten of Swords. They didn't ever betray anybody, but the person they were with betrayed them. The Three of Wands, they probably haven't had a serious relationship in about 3 years. And beautiful energy, I love the King of Pentacles. The King of Pentacles is a Taurus King. The Taurus King rules money and abundance, and this person's a very abundant person. And we have Scorpio energy along with Taurus energy. You are a perfect match for them, Pisces, because it shows that on the astrology wheel, you are opposites almost. So you could be involved with a Virgo, but you're involved with somebody with whom you are very compatible. While this story unfolds, let's get a little bit of message from Spirit for you in terms of how to stay grounded as this beautiful love story unfolds. A person who was wounded is really ready to come to the table and give their all. Give their all. All right. Serenity. Stay serene. You know, this card really speaks about compassion, acceptance, contentment, solitude, rest. I like that. Take a nap, rest, ponder, quiet, and sanctuary. You know, just, you have the wisdom. Look at this big owl. Wouldn't that be fun to wear to the Kentucky Derby? I mean, honestly, that would be a hat of all hats. All right. Or in Britain, you know, where they always wear all those beautiful hats. Okay. So hello, London. Hello, Britain. Hello, British Isles. Distance. You know, let this person work things out on their own. They'll come to the right conclusions for the right reasons when they're ready. And in the meantime, you do you. They'll do them. And it is beautiful. Pisces, it was wonderful spending this time with you. It was delightful for me. And I hope you enjoyed it. Take care. Bye-bye.